Gemini, I hope you're all doing great. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to your October love reading. So we're going to take a look and see what is coming in for your love life this month in October. How are things going to be for you? What are things going to be like around you? What are some of the experiences you'll have in your love life? I also want to take a look at what's going on around you guys now, and then we'll look at the near future. Okay, if it's your first time to my channel, I appreciate you clicking on the video. I do hope you enjoy the reading. My name is Lynn. This is Passion of Heart Tarot. Let's get into it, Gemini. Let's see what is coming in for you before I begin. Just want to take a moment to invite the white light, the Holy Spirit. So I can see where recently some of you have embraced what feels like it's a major change in your love life. That energy is around you now. So for some of you, like if it hasn't come to you yet, just know that like there's a huge change getting ready to come in for you. I mean, this is very, very beautiful energy. Some of you could have already embraced this and dove right into it. I can see Scorpio's energy around you, Gemini. I wonder if you guys are thinking of a Scorpio as you watch this, or maybe there's cross watchers for you, or that could be your moon or rising signs. But everything here shows me that for someone, this relationship that they've gotten into recently, it looks like, or maybe like something's changed between you and your current person or thing, and because of those changes for the better, things look very steady and official and stable between the two of you. See, I can pick up on the energy around you of someone who did a lot of waiting on the sidelines, just really letting things pass them by. I think that someone around you, whether it's you, Gemini, or the person that you were involved with, or should this be who's coming your way, I see the way that this person, it's not that they were cold, because it's like their heart is right there, but like there's precautions that they take when it comes to really opening up to someone and taking a chance. So for someone, this could even be like their first major relationship, or it just feels that way, you know, like comparing it to other relationships before, this feels different. This feels real. It feels significant. It feels strong. Because that's the huge change that this person has made is like, I'm just going to do it. I'm just gonna become a part of things. I don't want to be on the sidelines. I don't want to be a watcher anymore. I don't want time to keep passing me by. So I feel like, it's someone who went from being like cautious about things to being kind of daring and really bold. And you know, maybe it just feels that way to them. And that's beautiful, because I just see so much energy of someone who it looks like they've recently gotten into a relationship. Or like I said, maybe things between you and your current person have changed. It just seems like around you recently, Gemini, there's been like closure that's been found. Maybe on issues from the past, or whatever someone, you know, whatever it was that made them hold back, finding closure and moving forward, because the energy that's around you now, I mean, this is what people wish for. This is what people wish to have in their love life. You know, please don't think I'm saying you don't recognize this, or like you're not grateful enough. No, it's not meant to come across that way. But like this is what everyone wants, I feel, in their love life, because it is really feeling like I'm with my best friend. I'm with someone who supports me through everything. I'm with someone that's just like me in so many ways. I'm with someone that truly understands me. And it's just like this, that's mutual. It's this mutual feeling of everything is on track. Everything is in the right place. And I feel like what I'm getting from my person, I can absolutely rely and depend on them. So I wonder if you know, with this change coming through and like with the, just like a new chapter and big changes, with that energy here, I wonder if for any of you, is this your first like major commitment? Or, you know, that could be the case for someone here. Maybe they've just kind of dated casually, but this looks like it's on the next level of commitment with someone that is unlike anyone else. And I will tell you that that's a mutual feeling between the two of you. So the energy that's around you currently is very stable. It's just so much stability. And if anyone here feels like they feel that way about someone that they're involved with now, and maybe someone here knows that they were on the sidelines before, and you know, you're kind of looking for a message of advice from spirit about maybe to just give you that little last like push or nudge. This is safe. I just feel like that's what I need to get to. That's the whole point of it. Like, this is safe. This is right. This is stable. And maybe it's unlike anything you've ever had before, but you can trust it. You don't need to worry about it if you've had any worry, because I see where you have such a strong support system around you. Like, the person that I can see around you, Gemini, is not going to let you be alone through anything. They want to be there for you. They want to support you. They want to do anything they can to just uplift you. So the vibes around you and your love life look very special to me right now. And since it's what's currently around you, if you feel you haven't received this yet, know that it's like in the air, so to speak, around Gemini's energy. So there's a lot of promise here for you. I wonder if any of you are in this place and maybe you've yet to take that chance with your heart and open up. That's what that energy is. I'm telling you, if you do, you're gonna see significant and major changes in yourself, in your love life, because I know that what you stand to receive, like this is, I don't know how else to describe that energy other than it's what everyone wishes for in their love life. Because this is someone who, through thick and thin, ups and downs, no, like, no, I'm not gonna hold, I won't hold back from you. There's nothing that I'll keep from you. It's just very beautiful energy. And then the Ace of Pentacles, this is all new, fresh energy around you now. So whether it's between you and your current person and things just feel new and fresh, or it's a new relationship that some of you have recently gotten into, maybe you've had someone new come into your life. It's just amazing energy around you guys now. That's wonderful to see. Okay. And like I said, you know, if you feel you haven't received this, it's yours for the taking. It's around you now. Maybe someone here just needs to let themselves take a chance with their heart, kind of put themselves out there a little more rather than just like being on the sidelines and watching, like making myself a part of things. Because I know that if you do that, this is what you stand to receive. It's really a person around you now that I can see you being with forever. All right, Gemini. Now, let's take a look at the near future. Let's see what experiences are coming in for you in October. I see Cancer's energy coming through. I see Cancer's energy. I wonder if any of you are thinking, are you on the cusp of Cancer? Thinking of a Cancer, could be dealing with one, involved with one, cross watchers, or moon or rising. Okay, so I can see where everything around you now looks very beautiful to me. I feel like in the near future, either you or your person looks like they need support. This energy here, with the Chariot in reverse, and now that Queen of Cups is coming in upright, it almost looks like something between you and this person that was moving forward, there's a chance for it to like either come to a standstill or for someone to kind of be back and forth in their decisions, like I haven't made up my mind and about something, a decision. And then it looks like whoever it was that was in that place of being kind of cautious with their heart, it looks like there's a chance for them to slide back into that energy. There's a chance for them to do that. Don't think I'm saying that your connection is going to be in a bad place, because that's not what that energy is. But if someone here was very cautious about opening up their heart, and I had to tell them that it's safe for them. See, this is like the energy of having reservations again. Reservations to the point where I feel this person kind of, something was moving forward and they're not letting it move forward. So what this energy shows me is one of you feeling like you need support from the other one. See, this is why I talk about someone having the reservations and kind of going back and forth in a decision. Okay, so the fact that I keep picking up on a decision lets me know that in the near future, there's going to be something that the two of you are going to have to like make a choice on, or decisions that you have to make together, like as one. So that's very important and significant. I just feel where one of you is gonna be the strong one in the connection and the other person is, they're just not as strong and decisive and confident as the other one is. So what I see going on between the two of you is having to like really be there and carry the other one. And I don't mean that in a bad way, because I can already see where you guys have such a bond and such a commitment towards each other. And there's no way that like when one of you is down, you're gonna let them stay down. But I talk about being down, because when you see the Two of Pentacles in reverse, that lets me know that someone is very much like they're not grounded, they're not centered, and I just feel like maybe they have a lot going on. Maybe they have a lot going on in their life personally, where they're like good one day and then stressed out the next. Because this looks very stressful to me. This looks like one of you, they look very stressed. And so I feel like whoever is going through these stressors, their person, they're going to need their person so bad. And I know that when they're going through these stressors, they might kind of freeze up. Things get at a standstill. They don't know which way to go. They don't know what to choose. And I think the other one may feel like, oh, you're pulling back from me now. So it's like a period coming up where it's like, okay, put your money where your mouth is. You're going to have to be there to support your person. And don't think I'm saying like anything particularly bad is going to happen. I just feel like it's a lot of emotional stress. I just feel like someone needs a lot of support because they just feel overwhelmed. Maybe they're working a lot, taking on a lot of responsibilities. I feel like it comes from a personal place. And it just seems like this person has a lot on their plate. And because they have so much on their plate, I feel like they're just in a place where they're overwhelmed. They're tired, they're overwhelmed, and maybe they're not even getting good sleep. And that honestly could be something that just like throws them off. So in around Gemini's energy, I see one of you being off. Either it's you or your person. It's just spirit letting you know that it's time to like really be there for the other one. Things will kind of be put to the test in that way. But I don't want you to think that it's like a like something particularly like bad. I just feel like it's stress. That's just what it is. It's stress and someone who can't sleep well, and then I feel like because of their lack of sleep and their stress and oh, it's just like when this person needs to go to sleep, it looks like they have so much on their mind that they keep thinking about. So I wouldn't be surprised if someone gets like a lot of late night phone calls from their person, if you guys aren't there together. Late night phone calls or texts to their person saying, I can't sleep, things like that. So I just feel like I just see one of you taking care of the other one. And that's actually a beautiful thing. It really is because it's going to show you, around Gemini's energy, it's going to show you that you have someone that you can rely on, that you can depend on, that's going to be there for you when you feel down. So I can pick up on just one of you needing support, definitely getting the support, but then the challenges that kind of come along with something that looked like it was moving forward very quickly, and then it comes to a stop or a standstill. That's what it looks like. So there could be delays in the plans that you guys have made. I wonder what those plans are. For each of you, it's different, but I just feel like it looks like there's like blockages around those plans. Doesn't mean that it's going to be forever, but for some reason that energy is coming through with the blockages around it. Changing plans, switching things around. If you can help it. In October, I would say to if you don't have to, if there's something that doesn't need to happen per se and it can be held off, it just seems like trying to plan something around your energy, Gemini, looks like it appears to come across as stressful. So if you can avoid making like big plans or big changes or big decisions, and just kind of keep things business as usual. That's your advice from spirit. But if that can't be helped, and like you guys are like, there's something that you're getting ready to change or do or plan, just know that one of you is gonna need a lot more support. Like one of you is gonna be stronger than the other one. That's what I can see going on. Okay, I wanna look at this Five of Pentacles. I'm sorry, Two of Pentacles. It's funny because it's coming through here again, and now Capricorn's energy. Are you guys thinking of a Capricorn? Or it could be, who you're involved with, moon or rising energies. I feel like when I see someone going through that place of like, because I feel like one of you is gonna let your emotions get the best of you. And if you, someone here watching this, feels like, yeah, I feel like that can be me. I tend to get very like emotional, or I just feel like it's important for you. I know it's not the easiest thing to, if you're stressed out, you're stressed out, and that's just what it is. But when you see the devil energy come through around a person that's so stressed out like that, it's like this fine line of knowing when to give the other one space and when to hold on to them, when to comfort them. That's not always the easiest thing to determine because I can see someone being in that position like, do you need space or do you want me to comfort you? Like, what do you want me to do here? So for whoever it is that is in this space, just remember that your person is not a mind reader. If there's something that you need from them in the moment, tell them, you know, rather than getting upset or angry that they don't know what to do for you right then and there, how to approach you right then and there. Because you don't want to do, you know, because I just feel like this is the devil's energy, you know? That could be letting someone see a really ugly side of you that, you know, maybe stress brought out that ugly side. So when I look at the energy from all different perspectives, what you need in the moment, you have to communicate it to your person. Like, if you need space, tell them you need space. And whoever is told that, give this person their space. Or if you say, you know, I need support, whatever, I feel lost, I need you to be here for me, you know, be there for them. I just feel like, because when I look at things from both perspectives, who's on the receiving end of that? It's like, well, what do you want? Like, I'll do whatever you need me to do. Just tell me, what can I do to help you? Because I can even see someone maybe saying those words. And whoever is in need of help at the time, they really have to be honest and express what it is that they need, whether it's like for them to pull them closer or to give them space. But don't be mad if your person doesn't know what to do right then and there, because they are not a mind reader. And I just feel like, you know, because someone is very stressed out, it looks like they're just so stressed out. So I know that stress can kind of bring out the worst in someone. That's what I could see potential for that. Okay, I'm gonna look at this. Nine of Wands, just to give me a little more insight into what someone might need, what they're going through, why I see them feeling like they have a lot of pressure. That they're dealing with a lot of pressure. The Knight of Pentacles is coming through around that pressure. And then when you see energy like this, I feel like if someone wants advice from spirit, because what this shows me is maybe it, because it looks like there's big changes that you guys are going through currently. So I feel like in October, if you can slow things down and make things as like steady as possible, I feel like that's what will help the most around Gemini's energy. Because I feel like if one of you in this connection feels like things are moving fast, I'm stressed out, this is a lot of pressure, then I feel like there's negative repercussions in the connection. Like I said a moment ago, if there's things that you can avoid and kind of keep the business as usual, then I would suggest, you know, your advice from spirit is to. But if there are some things that are just changing and it can't be helped, you may have to be there for your person, kind of bear with them. It looks like things could be a bit touchy at times, but if you can slow things down and avoid added pressures, that's definitely the way to go. Because I just feel like one of you in this connection around Gemini's energy is just not doing good with stress and pressures. And it almost seems like everything is so magnified. Like even the littlest of things could get this, like just really affects this person's stress, stress, stress. Someone is very stressed around you. You know, I'm reading for you guys, but it's a general reading, so that's why I'm kind of like looking at things from both perspectives, depending on which side of this you feel you're on. Because if you're the one that is stressed out the way that I can see, there's a lot of useful advice from spirit about maybe how, like what to say to your person. Or if you feel like your person is in the place where they're stressed out, I feel like it's also useful advice on maybe how to approach them, how to look at things, and maybe even insight into what's going on, especially if they're just like weird or hot and cold and they're not opening up about why. Okay, I want to look at this magician's energy. It's just here, you guys, you know, it's just here. Your Gemini energy is coming through. So I wonder if any of you are involved with another Gemini. When I talk about it's just here, like there's just like defensiveness. Defensiveness. I feel like someone kind of showing their temper. And then when you see the nine, the seven, and the nine of wands, I just feel like you guys could be in a situation where it's difficult for you to know how to approach your person, deal with your person. And really, this is just stemming from them being under a lot of stress. It just feels like they have so many things coming at them at once that they are really caving under the pressure, under the attention. This is a lot of extra attention. I feel that someone all of a sudden, like boom, they have all of this attention on them. I wonder what that means, especially like when I think about what do they do for a living? Because why would this person all of a sudden it's like their center stage? So maybe they even get elevated, they get elevated in their career. They could get a promotion. They could have a big presentation that they need to make. It's like all eyes are on this person. They're on Front Street. They're in a leadership position. It's like they have so much coming at them all at once. So it's definitely like, I mean, these are good things because for them to be elevated, you know, to receive an elevated role at work, a promotion, all of this attention on them. It's positive attention, but I just feel like for whatever reason, they're not doing well with all of this added extra attention and focus on them. I feel like it could be career related, but for others of you, where things are so touchy between you and this person, and then when you see this kind of like devil energy, these lovers chained to each other, I just think it's important to know like when to push forward and when to back off. Now, I know you're not a mind reader either. So if someone here throughout Gemini's energy feels like, you know what, I just need space, tell your person that you need space rather than like just getting annoyed with them or upset with them if you feel like it's just too much. You know, I hate to put it like that. Like I don't mean to sound mean, but this can even show me a lot of like clingy energy. So I just feel like it's kind of touchy around you guys. It is. Things are touchy around you, and I do see where one of you know, if we get back to the energy where this is like work related or just added attention, responsibilities, maybe one of you has to pick up the slack for your coworker. Because that's what it looks like. All of a sudden, I have all of this attention on me. That's what it feels like. And all these things I'm responsible for, and all these things that I have to do. And whoever is in that position, they don't do well. They're caving under the pressure. So it's like touchy because I know where they need support, but then I also know how they need space. So you guys could even have something that goes on with your person around their career that puts delays in plans that the two of you have, plans that you were making. So I feel like there's a lot of solid advice for someone here from Spirit. Although I see a lot of pressure, I see a lot of stress, I see where things can be touchy at times. You know, don't think it's like steady throughout the whole month and like it's gonna break you guys up. No, that's not what it's like. It's just kind of like knowing when to be there and knowing when to kind of back off and give the other one space. I feel like obviously the best way to know when to do that is if you guys communicate appropriately with each other. So definitely a lot of emphasis on the communication between you and your person. Be open, be honest. The worst thing that you can do is keep things inside. Presume that the other one knows what you're thinking and feeling, and then get irritated when they don't do things the way that they should. Do you know what I mean? So communication, effective communication is super important. But I think that's why I like to look at the present, because, you know, it's just important for you guys to know that you have a very, very special connection. There's major changes around you. Big things are happening around Gemini. Big things are happening around Gemini's energy, even in like a career for someone. Big changes in your love life. I just feel like in October, I can see one of you being stressed out because of everything that's going on and changing. So effective communication will definitely help things be a lot smoother and easier around you guys. And I just think it's important, you know, for you guys to know how special the connection is. How things really are on the right track. This is just like a bump in the road. And, you know, like I said, how I just feel like the best thing for you guys to take away, even though there's a lot of details in the reading, the best thing for you to take away is knowing how effective communication, like how beneficial that can be for the two of you. Like if you need them, tell them you need them. If you need space, tell them you need space. And I feel like it's something that will be respected. I think it will even be a relief for someone, because it's like, well, what do you want from me? What do you need from me right now? Just tell me. And if you tell them, things will be a lot easier. And then I just feel like it's good news also. And for whoever it is that is in this new elevated position of power, try not to let things overwhelm you. You know, you were put in this space because you're qualified for it. You can handle it. You can. I feel like I have to give someone a word of encouragement here. Just take it all in stride. Just take it all in stride. That's it. And I feel like something that's easy for me to say, but I know will help someone if they can utilize this advice when it's actually happening, to not get so caught up in the moment, to just think about how things were before and the beautiful changes that have happened around you. So to really lean into this energy of counting your blessings, and to also think forward and to think about the bigger picture and to think about things long term, because this energy is very short term. And I can see where someone gets like so stressed out and caught up in a moment, but it's very short term energy. But if they were to, you know, try and set, that's why I talk about centering and grounding their energy. Because if they do that, they'll look at things from a different perspective. Because these are not bad problems to have. I'm telling you, this is like being put in the forefront. It's like being in a leadership position. It could even spell a promotion at work for someone. All of this extra added attention, responsibilities. And I just feel like I'm telling you about this because there's a lot of benefits that come along with being in that position. Okay, you guys, so just a lot of advice for you, Gemini. Advice that I didn't really expect to see. You know, I never really know what's going to come up in your love reading, but that's what I can see going on throughout October. All right, I love you guys so much. Of course, I'll be back with more readings throughout the month, and I just want to say thank you. I do hope that you enjoyed the reading. I hope it was helpful for you. If it was, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, maybe share it if you know that there's someone that will enjoy it, take something away from it. That would be great. And if you haven't already subscribed, I do hope that you'll subscribe to my channel. Thank you again, Gemini. I love you so much. I'll see you in the next reading.